Steel Belton Radio. Hello, it's me. I'm a voice from your past. Now can you tell me, well, how long has it been since we last spoke? Oh, our paths they did cross. Yeah, for words, you know, I guess I'm at a loss.
Plume. I play in a band. In 99, we did 240, or just shy of 240 shows. This year, we're not going to do quite 240, but we're going to close to 200 anyway.
Dave Klym and I play the guitar. We get in the van, and we go to another town. We play, and if there's a long haul for the next day, we'll just pack up and go all night, and it's constant every day.
My name's Ernie Basiliadis, and I play the drums. I could do this for another 10 years and not have a dime, but I mean, I'll have a big smile on my face.
My name is William Meck Myers. I'm a working musician. I think I've been really blessed to be able to, you know, to be on the road with these guys.
I think the fact that there was never an audition for this band
and that they're all, you know, there really was, and it was just like, can you play guitar? Okay, great. And these guys are friends first, and play music second.
Belted radios, about radio stations that play music they want to play, not what they're told to play, right? And they're few and far between, but they're out there. You got to really look for them.
Dream, I turn on my steel belted radio, and hearing all the songs that you don't hear on your normal radio. They will never give them the chance to start, to make their way up to the top of some pop chart. All my DJs said, hey son, it's just a song that matters now. Just a song that matters now. It's all it ever was supposed to be. Songs that were ours. Cause some station managers might get slanted towards advertising dollars and taking all of us for granted. Oh, my DJ said, hey son, just a song that matters now. It's just a song that matters now. Hey baby, why don't you bring back John Hyatt and bring back Lyle Love, and you can bring him back on Steel Belt Radio. Why don't you bring back Bob Snyder and bring back Todd Snyder? Won't you bring him back on Steel Belt Radio? Why won't you bring back Ron Sexsmith and bring back Red Eagle Smith and bring him back, baby, on Steel Velvet Radio, on Steel Velvet Radio, Steel Velvet Radio, yeah.
Bring back Fred Eaglesmith.
Sorry, when I see a microphone, I just naturally have to talk into it. Check.
It's the same every night. Same old thing.
Oh, we gotta fix that, Dave. You may want to gaff that. Or crazy glue.
Cup of coffee. Now you know where the cream and sugar is. Or maybe you'd rather some whiskey. You know where I keep it hid, where I always did. Listen, I don't want to talk about it. We'll be right back. myself a cup of coffee. Cause it's too late anyhow. You know, it's a shame we couldn't talk to each other then, honey. The way we're talking to each other now. It's over.
A song, and you know, and I sort of come up with a lyric, whatever. I write it for no other reason than for to give some sense of comfort for myself, and in hope that it's not too eccentric or too far outside that other people won't be able to relate to it.
Well, the one that gets me every night is Marilyn Monroe and Joe DiMaggio. This song, it's one of the chances where, you know, the rest of us get to sort of sit back and, you know, and actually watch Mike.
Telephone rings way too much, but not nearly enough with you on the other end of the line. Said, you know, you can still call me. Well, lately I've been thinking about everything, but something leaves me stranded in between. Yeah, stranded in between. She's my Marilyn Monroe, and I'm her Joe DiMaggio. Marilyn Monroe and DiMaggio. Together, but forever linked, like birds of a feather, baby. When our spirits start to sink, yeah, we're forever linked. But the telephone rings way too much, but not nearly enough with you on the other end of the line. She said, you know, you could still call me. She said, you know, why don't you still call? She's my Marilyn Monroe, and I'm her Joe DiMaggio. A Marilyn Monroe and DiMaggio. Yeah, she my Marilyn Monroe, and I'm her Joe DiMaggio. Marilyn Monroe and DiMaggio, DiMaggio, DiMaggio.
It was supposed to be Demi Moore and Bruce Willis, but it just didn't roll off the tongue very well. First time we played here, we pulled in at like 3 a.m. and we didn't really know what we were getting ourselves into. We stay and go to sleep, and it's the most comfortable beds in the world. It's like being at your grandmother's house or something. And we wake up the next morning with the hotel shaking. I don't know what's going on. I open my window, and there's the steam engine. And I'm like, what? What just happened? Where are we? I felt like it was 1957 or something, you know?
Train coming. I want someone to let me. terrain come. We're all in all these fields of youth. Are you a train coming, seeking what is known for truth? Are you a train coming? Are you a train coming? Are you a train coming? Terrain coming.
Address or a phone number. I live in I live here in this van.
Yeah, welcome to our home. Don't worry about taking your shoes off.
The thing that I found with traveling as much as we have is that people are the same everywhere. Everybody wants to leave their town.
Well, she bought herself a ticket for a midnight train. Yeah, she's waiting in the station by the pinball machine. The beat up suitcase holds her favorite things. Yeah, the only thing I left behind is a diamond ring. You see, the life she been leading's gonna bring her down. The 12:15 gonna cover some ground. Yeah, the 12:15 gonna cover some ground, baby. You know it. Oh, let's go. Well, I fill up a car with the gasoline. A pack of cigarettes and wipe the windshield clean. An ocean of emotions running round in his brain. Parked out on the highway for some passing terrain. The life he believes better bringing him down. But the elder kind of some ground. His roots are here, but that don't slow him down. The Eldorado, she'll just be covering. Eldorado gonna cover some ground. Eldorado gonna cover some ground. But she was leaving him, he was leaving her. Well, oh yeah, who left him first? Ain't no one know for sure. They'll just be covering. Eldorado gonna cover some ground. Eldorado gonna cover some ground. Oh yeah. Some ground. Yeah, the Eldorado gonna cover some ground, believe it. He's at a filling station on a public phone. Now he has a red machine that says, oh, we're not home. Won't you please leave a message right out of the town? Sell the phone, I'm Mr. We Ain't Home. She's thinking about her doing the same thing too. She get to St. Louis, she just might do it. Just might do it when she get to St. Louis. Just might do it. Oh, when she get to St. Louis, well, yeah. Well, she bought herself a ticket when the sun come around. It's gonna take her on back to a northern town. Yeah, be standing out loud, hell, he'd never even know. I could be waiting for him when he walks through that door.
So ain't it funny how the great minds sing alike, and fools tell them if they come by, The sun arose, mirror shows he's wearing a brown. You point the Eldorado straight to a northern, Eldorado to a northern town, Eldorado to a northern town. Point the Eldorado to a northern town, Eldorado to a northern town, yeah. I've heard it, baby, come on. Yeah. Hey, baby, Eldorado, huh, in the 1215. Eldorado, huh, in the 1215. Eldorado, huh, in the 1215, yeah. It kind of make them feel mean, baby.
Writing is such a weird thing. I wish I had a better handle on it. You know what I mean? Because I'd write more. But it's just such a weird animal, because I don't really pay attention or realize what lyrically I'm doing until months after the fact. And I look back and go, okay, that kind of makes sense about this part of my life.
It's about trials and tribulations of relationships and being on the road, you know, and what we do, you know. It's just like traveling and traveling and traveling and meeting different people and relationships that are just been busted up, and because you're never there. And it's about life and how he sees it, you know. He's the storyteller for sure.
Paid to do. We play for free and drive and load gear for minimum wage.
The main job is loading and unloading. And when you play,
would you play for free?
Well, yeah. That's what we basically do anyway. You know. Jeez, there's places we paid to play.
The only real work truly is loading in, loading out, and driving.
Yeah, that's it, man.
Putting up with grief at hotel rooms. You know, no, we've got, you know, two single rooms, non-smoking.
As Mike's been doing this for 12 years. He draws his inspiration from a myriad of levels. As far as his songwriting goes, you know, lost love, life on the road.
You know, I like traveling. I like driving. I could drive all night right now.
Because you got the trucker in you, your dad's a trucker.
Yeah. I'd say within an hour into the trip, you sort of fall into that rhythm. Where the telephone poles have a tempo, you know, and then while we're driving, I'll go find that melody and just, you know, sort of tap on the steering wheel and just sort of work on lyrics in my head. Songs are waiting to be written there all the time.
Stepped out the front door, she never was too sure that road out front would take her is gonna take away. Maybe today, maybe LA. She said it started with that feeling, sent her mind reeling. She longed for leaving with nothing to say. Maybe today, or maybe LA. Well, can you tell me, mister, just what it was that we did? You know, we acted like we were the chosen ones, but we were nothing more than kids. She said, I can't sleep in the bed that we made. I can't sleep in the bed that we made. So maybe LA. Lit a cigarette and stared, then said, besides, the weather's there. Well, anyway, maybe LA. Yeah, well, can you tell me, mister, just what it was that we did? You know, we acted like we were rebels, but we were nothing more than kids. She said, I can't sleep in the bed that we made. No, I can't sleep in the bed that we made. Maybe, yeah. Tell me, mister, just what it was that we did. Yeah, we acted like we were rivals, but we were nothing more than kids. She said, I can't sleep in the bed that we made. Now, in the script, this is my character's cue to fade. Maybe LA. Well, can you tell me, mister, just what it was that we did? You know, we acted like we were rebels, but we were nothing more than kids. Well, I can't sleep in the bed that we made. No, I can't sleep in the bed that we'd made. So maybe, yeah.
Steel Welton Radio.
We celebrate tonight. 'cause it's easier, easier that way. I said it's easier, easier.